Welcome back to Buzzard on Guitar. Today, fantastic American band Counting Crows and their opening track off their second album, Recovering the Satellites. Catapult's a really, really dark song, I think, full of power and spite. But it features some really clever guitar work in this, really well thought out, I think, guitar playing. So I have gone the extra mile again for you lucky people. So I've tabbed out what I'm playing. Just about the kind of towards the ending of the song, it's pretty hard to hear what's kind of going on in the mix, and I've slowed it down and I've listened. So if just obviously, you know, not that the guys will ever watch this video, but it's just a little disclaimer that it's what I've come up with. It does seem to work. It works really well, I've got to say. Of course, when it gets into that repeated, last repeated theme, which I'll go on about, I'll just recap. That's quite clear what's going on. I'm just going to talk about some bits and pieces, what's going on in the song, and then you get stuck into it. Opens up with that, of course, the E chord. The opening figure. Based around E major, kind of that E major scale. The chords is a little interesting thing here you can try as well. But the chords under that are E, D, and A. Okay. In that phrase, there's a couple of tied notes. So the note kind of just pushed before the D chord is A. Okay. And then it goes into the G sharp. So this would be the E chord. D. And then we have that third, the F sharp with the G sharp. Now, what's interesting there is that if you play a D chord, okay, and then if you flatten that fifth, okay, arguably, you could say, I'm going to throw the volume down a little bit to try and clean that up. I've got the tone of the actual song on. So if you flatten the fifth of the D chord there, we get a D, a G sharp. Okay, we get the D again, of course, and the F sharp. You could actually perceive that as an E7, which would be a little, in jazz terms, I'm not turning this into a jazz thing, but probably maybe. But you could actually just perceive that as an E7, before going back to your A. Okay, over the A as well, the tied note there, again, it kind of, it's very heavy on the G sharp. So you've got this, on the second time. E. Yeah, the G sharp. Both times, actually, both reps. So again, you could actually perceive that as an A major 7. Just clean that up a little bit. Hopefully it's cleaned up. I've not got the cans on. Okay, so listen to this new progression if you wanted to. Just, you know, if you're ever doing a solo version on the acoustic or something, you could have E. Okay, D. D, E7, and A major 7. Okay. I hope that sounds good. I ain't got the cans on. So, you know, you could have that, you know, again, not that you'd want to destroy the song by doing that, but I just thought it was really interesting how this G sharp could be used and looked at in the chord progression. The second part, again, arpeggios here. Okay, so B. The chord progression here is B. Okay, so B, A to E, okay. B major. Okay, if you think of the traditional bar chord, you've just got the top three notes. He's playing the G sharp and the E. Okay. So over the progression there, B major, A, and then that note E pushes into the E chord. And a little bit of play on the, just again, it's a very subtle bend on the B, just spices it up. You're not really considering the C note to be part of the harmony. Okay. Some really nice, subtle, but I think clever guitar playing. There. Let's have a look at anything else in there. The solo is what it is, beautifully phrased. On the second time, I did want to say on that. Again, solid with the chords there of A. Then just flattening that A to the G sharp. The consistent note is always the E, so you've got kind of an, you know, you've got the root and the fifth of the A, and then the G sharp with the E, so really strong on the E chord. The solo, brilliant solo in there, another couple, again, kind of repeated themes, some tremolo picking as well, so, you know, get that alternate picking going there, and also just over the chord as well. I think when you listen to it, he's got a wah effect as well on there, so you'll hear wow, and it's kind of, I think quite possibly he's kind of just for me, as a hazard and a guess, he's going from foot down to foot up. He's just, it sounds like a wah effect, whether added on afterwards or played live, who knows. And then again, the last theme there. Okay, over your harmony there. A really, really, again, I use this word a lot, fantastic. I'm trying to think some more. Stupendous, how's that? Counting Crows really are a brilliant band. If you've never discovered them, again, it's easy to think Mr. Jones, pop band, you're mistaken, give them a whirl. Album recommendations, the debut album, which Mr. Jones was off, he's got some amazingly beautiful moments in, and really uplift. Omaha, songs like that are fantastic. Recovering the Satellites, I think, to me, is it's hard to say darker, because there's a lot of melancholy in Counting Crows music. But anyway, this song, Catapult, from Recovering the Satellites, I truly recommend. So have fun, and I'll see you soon.